And because of wide and rapid spread disobedience, hard-headedness, stuck-up, non-giving, non-tithing, non-participatory people, God had to send some stern words
yes, sir.
To the prophet
yes, sir.
Jeremiah.
Yeah.
You would take note that Jeremiah preached 20 to 30-something odd years, and not one person walked down the aisle and gave the preacher the right hand to join the church.
Come on, Pastor.
Jeremiah preached for a number of years. Nobody came in and asked for a deliverance. Oh, preached for a number of years. Nobody came and gave their life to the Lord. I tell you, it was rough for Jeremiah. In other words, Jeremiah had many reasons to lay his hand on his pillow at night and soak them with dreadful tears after all that he would see on a daily basis. Can I talk to you for a minute? It is a bad situation. Watch this. With the people that God called by name with his own mouth, delivered from the bondages of Egypt, drove them through the wilderness, crossing the Red Sea, and give them a land flowing with milk and honey, houses that they did not build, fields that they did not plant, and they repay him with disobedience. Can I talk to you for a while?
Come on.
can you put the preacher in the corner?
Yeah.
How can you try to lock up the hands and the mouth of the preacher? The scribe, the secretary, if you will, and calls him in and tell him to get pen and paper. I want you to write down everything that God has told me to tell you to put on the paper. Can I tell you today, we need preachers need to say exactly what God said. We don't need preachers that's high-timing and hooping and hollering and never know what the Bible actually says. But we need somebody that's going to tell it like it T.I. is. We need somebody who's going to open the book, tell it like it is. If you need to put the bottle down, put the bottle down. If you need to let that woman go, let that man go, let him go. Because you'll be better because the word of God says it's better for you. Say the preacher meddling, but he's trying to help you get blessed.
Amen. Come on, Pastor.
With the preacher who tells the truth.
Yeah.
But we'll pack buildings with lying prophets.
Yeah.
All right.
He's going to say what does say.
Yeah.
He said, Baruch, write it the way the Lord gave it to me. Don't leave nothing out, don't add nothing to it, don't take nothing away. Put it just like God said. Whoever it hit. Come on, St. Peter, help me. I tell St. Peter all the time, I ain't trying to hit you, but if I hit you, I wasn't trying to miss you. And anyway, if you hit me, that's
it.
A midnight creeper.
Come on.
And the word of God says, stop. It's better for you, isn't it?
I hear you.
I can't get no help from you.
Come on now.
You pray with me a little while.
It's all right now.
Here he is. Write it.
Write it.
Put it down.
Right.
And I want you to stop nowhere. You take it straight to the king.
Yeah.
I want to ask you what happened, the Lord bless you. My God, I know I'm about to get in trouble.
Come on!
Thank God for knowing the people and brethren that I have that surrounds me. Thank God for you brothers who care for me. But there were some folks in presence. Some other folk that had to receive the letter before it got to
all right.
It's amazing how some people like to get the word before it gets to the right
person.
They receive it and they go and have counsel about it and talk about it before they can give it to the king. And you know how they will do. Well, let's go get them and knock them up first. And y'all read the Bible. Real quick, when Jesus was born, King Herod knew that there was some wise men. He inquired of the wise men about where this thing is. He said, I've seen the star. He said, I've seen the star, and it's shining brighter than it ever had before. Let y'all go see what this thing is all about. Watch this. Herod knew what it was all about. Can I tell you something about the enemy? What we're trying to act like is not and it don't work that way. The enemy know your people better than you. Watch this. The enemy know your future better than you. The enemy not only know your future, but he knows what's in store for you. But what his job is to try to distract you from seeing what you really are and what you could really be. What a whole bunch of nonsense and mosquitoes. is and what it is, and come back and bring the message back.
Right.
He said that when you bring the word back, I want to go and worship. That was a lie. All I'm trying to tell you, I gotta get to the story right there, is this. What Herod wanted to do was kill the truth before the truth got out. What did but he knew what that paper was gonna be?
Yeah.
He knew that paper was gonna replace him
yeah.
without taking his seat.
Y'all ain't
said nothing to me. Y'all ain't said nothing to me. You heard about a seat. Some people now they can take everything that's around you and leave you in your seat.
Yeah.
Y'all don't like the truth, but you just have to know that the enemy don't want you to make it.
Go ahead.
Read your Bible, amen, in the 10th Sunday school sometimes. Here it is, amen. He locked them up. He said, we're going to take this matter to the king. Lock them up. Don't let nobody else see him. What they were trying to do was prevent the story from getting out to other folks, and the king would have to come back here. Kind of like this president we have here. So lock them up. Let's take the scroll. Pour over it ourselves. Then we'll give it to the king.
Yeah.
The king gets the news, and what the king does once he gets the news, read your Bible. The Bible says while the scribe was literally reading it off, reading out his demise and his destruction and God's punishment for him, the Bible says he took a knife and cut it while he was yet reading.
Yeah.
Start talking to you and say, they trying to push the message your way, saying, why are you reading God's word? And the Lord has sent a strong word through his man, the preacher, the pastor, the prophet of God. Somebody want to tell you to check the messages and all that kind of stuff. And somebody want to pass you a note, amen. The whole matter because it hurts so bad. Sometimes you have to tell it like a T.I. is, no matter how bad it hurts. Locked up the preacher.
Yes, sir.
Cut the word.
Yes.
Then guess what he did? He said, stop reading it. He cut it, snatched it out of his hand, and threw it in the fire. From the hill.
That's
not what I really want to preach. I want to preach the economy of God. I want to tell you how good it is to bless the man of God. I want to tell you how Saul, when his father's animals was lost, he sent his father out to look for the sheep, amen, and the oxen and all the animals that was lost, and they were torn and looking for it, and they could not find it. And I wanted to talk about that. And when they got ready, amen, to go back home because they hadn't found them, Saul was worried that his father would think that some beast or somebody has killed him or robbed him, and he told his servant, let's go back. The servant had the presence of mind, y'all listen to me. The servant had presence of mind and said, wait a minute, stop where you are. Let's go into the hill country where the man of God is. There is a prophet, there is a seer. Watch the text while we can go when we don't have nothing to give. Y'all missing me already. I want to talk about the economy. I want to talk about how it is to search out and seek out the man of God so you can be blessed. Y'all missing me. He said, if we go, we won't have nothing to bring. The servant said, wait a minute. I kept 1/4 part of a shekel of silver. That should be enough. Y'all missing me right there. How many of you take time out to say, let me put something back for the man of God?
Turn the word, but it's a fact that God got another. But somebody say, God got another.
want to say, greater grace, you are most honored today.
Amen.
That you would set aside a day to honor the man of God.
Amen.
I'm saying that because that's part of God's economy.
Come on.
Yeah. The more you do for the man of God, the better your economy is going to be. Who I really want to preach. Jeremiah 36.
Come on, Pastor. Bless the Lord.
Jeremiah 36. I